Hi, and welcome to Questacon Science Time. My name's Dion.
And I'm BJ.
And today we're talking about autumn. Come and join us.
Let's go.
Wake up, sun and moon. It's science time. It's science time. Wake up, skeleton. It's science time. It's science time.
Anyone guess what we're talking about today? If you look around the room, what do you think we might be talking about? Any ideas?
What do you think we're talking about today?
Well, today we're actually going to be talking about autumn. We're talking about autumn. Now, was it cold or was it warm this morning?
Autumn.
Yeah, autumn. Was it cold or was it warm this morning?
Warm.
It was warm, was it? You might have been in a big jacket, maybe. Did anyone feel a bit cold this morning? Yeah, I felt a bit cold this morning. So, the reason it's cold, is it summer at the moment? It's not summer, so it's not summer at the moment, it's autumn at the moment, so it's a little bit colder. You don't get cold. Well, you're very lucky not to get cold, especially in this sort of weather. The sun does go away, doesn't it, sometimes? It gets a little bit cold. Good work. It's taking a sit on your bottom. Now, what happens in autumn? Does anyone know? What happens in autumn? Have a look at this picture. Can anyone tell me what happens in autumn? The leaves fall down, don't they? Well done. They do fall down. And what else happens to the leaves in the trees? They also change colour as well, don't they? They change colour. So what colours can you see in the picture? What colours can you see?
Orange.
We can see orange. What other colours? Can anyone see yellow? Hands up, who can see yellow? Can anyone see yellow in the picture? You might be able to see yellow in the picture. There's a bit of yellow over here. Whoops, over there. Can anyone see orange in the picture? Maybe orange as well? Yeah, and can anyone see green in the picture? Hands up, who can see green in the picture? Can you see green in the picture? Yeah, maybe. So we've got green in the picture as well. Now, we've got two different types of trees in this picture here. We have some trees that change colour and some trees that don't change colour. You can see red, lots of different colours, well done. So we're going to talk about some trees called evergreens first. Now, evergreens, they're always green, even in autumn. So you can see here, these leaves, what colour are these leaves? They're green, aren't they? They are green. And these greens are really waxy. Well, these leaves are really waxy. So it means that they stay green all year round. There are also some other leaves, which are very, very small, like these ones here. And these ones also stay green all year round. Has anyone got a tree like this at home? Do you have a tree like this at home?
I got a tree in the home.
You have? And does it look a little bit like this, maybe? Maybe an evergreen as well that doesn't change colour? You don't have an evergreen. You might have different types of trees then. We've got big trees with lots and lots of leaves. Well, then you might have a tree that changes colour.
I do like that.
You do like that as well. So we're going to have a look at some leaves now that change colour. So these are called evergreens. These trees, though, the trees that have leaves that change colour are called deciduous. Can everyone say deciduous for me?
Deciduous.
It's a pretty big word, pretty big scientific word. What happens with a deciduous tree is it starts out green, just like this one here. Just like all the trees are in springtime, they're nice and green. But what happens in autumn is all the green starts to disappear. So what's happening with this leaf is the green is starting to disappear and there's another colour underneath. What colour can you see?
Yellow.
Well done, yellow. So we've got green and yellow here. But what happens is more green starts to disappear and more yellow, you can see more yellow, and even more green starts to disappear until eventually all of the green is gone. And what colour is this leaf?
Yellow!
It's yellow, isn't it? So all of the green has gone. Now what happens is this yellow is always there. And the green starts to disappear and shows the yellow. So we'll show you a little bit of an experiment here. We've got some orange here. So this is the colour of the leaf before in autumn. And then we have our green as well. Now, can you see any of the orange?
Not really.
Not really, you can't see any of the orange because the green is all covering it up. And what happens, in autumn, the tree stops making the green bit and the green bit starts to disappear. Can anyone start to see the orange? You can see a bit more. And all the green eventually goes away and underneath is the beautiful autumn colour. Very, very cool indeed. So these are deciduous trees that change colour in autumn. Now, what happens to leaves when they've fallen on the ground? What happens to the leaves on the ground? They sometimes wind around, yeah, they blow around, don't they? Now, has anyone ever raked up leaves before? Do you help Mum and Dad rake the leaves at home? Do you rake the leaves at home? It's quite a lot of fun to rake up leaves. It's also fun to play in leaves as well. Now, when the leaves... And acorns as well, definitely.
Oh, I like acorns.
Very, very cool. So what happens is when we rake up our leaves, sometimes we'll put it on something called a compost heap. Now, compost heap has got lots of bugs that like to eat leaves and that sort of stuff. Now, these sorts of animals, one of them is a really, really long, slimy one that lives under the ground. Can anyone think of what animal that might be? What do you think? A wiggly worm, well done. So we've got worms, there are also cockroaches and centipedes and snails as well. And all these animals are called composters. Can everyone say composters for me?
Composters.
Composters. Composters like to eat old leaves. They really, really do like quite a lot. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna pretend to be some trees now. So what we have is we've got some leaves and I want everyone to find your favorite leaf. So we're gonna put some leaves in the middle here. Can everyone find their favorite leaf for me? Come and find your favorite leaf. There, we'll see if you can find your favourite leaf. There we are, well done. Now, can everyone find a leaf that's the same colour as their favourite leaf? So you need to have two leaves, one that's the same colour. Can you find a
look?
See if you can find two leaves that are the same colour.
Got two, well done.
Now, what we're going to do is we're going to pretend to be big trees now. So I need everyone to get their two leaves. We're going to stand up now. Everyone's standing up. And I want everyone to get your big branches and spread them really, really wide.
Really big.
Spreading your leaves. So holding onto your leaves, spreading your branches really, really wide. You're a big tree. And what happens to the leaves in autumn? Does anyone know? They start to drop down, don't they? So we're going to drop our leaves when I say ready, set, go. So ready, set, go. Drop your leaves just like an autumn tree. Well done. So sitting on your bottoms again. So now that the leaves are all on the ground, there are some things that like to eat those leaves. So what we have now is we've got some composters. So I want everyone to come and get a composter. See if you can pick your favourite composter.
There's worms and
millipedes. We've got worms, and millipedes, snails, all sorts of different types. There we are. So see if you can find your favourite composter. Then I want you to find a leaf for me. Find your favourite leaf again. Everyone find your favourite leaf. And we're going to feed our composters. So everyone get your leaf. And your compost is going to eat the leaf. You ready? So, nom 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 nom. So they really like to eat the dead leaves on the ground. So everyone, putting down a leaf. I want you to get a new leaf this time. See if you can find a different leaf. Find another leaf. And we're going to feed our composter another leaf. You ready? So our composters like to eat those leaves. Go! Nom 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 nom. Likes to eat those leaves. Well done. So I want everyone to put your composters back into the container for me. Putting all your composters back in the container. Good cleaning up. Well done. Do you want to put your composter in there? Well done. We've also got another container here for our leaves. Can everyone help me pack up our leaves? So putting our leaves in there. Thank you very much for your help. Do you want to put your composter back in there?
Well done.
So putting all the leaves back in the container. Good work.
Very good at picking up. Do you pick up things at home?
Hopefully you clean this well at home. You're doing a very, very good job. Well done. So putting it all in the box for me. Packing them all away. Well done. Well done. So this is like what we do at home. When you rake up the leaves, you put them all into a big box or into a compost bin. There we are.
And
so,
you can pretend to be a tree at
and
home
another
well.
One. Well
lots
done. So sitting on your bottoms, everyone. Sitting on your bottoms. Now, we've also got other composters, cockroaches as well. And BJ's actually got a real cockroach to show us, which she's going to go fetch now.
I'll just go get it.
Now, hands up, who's got cockroaches at home? Has anyone got cockroaches at home? Have you got cockroaches at home? It's not nice to admit that we have cockroaches, but sometimes we do. We do have cockroaches. So you might have cockroaches that look a little bit like this one here. You don't have them. You're very, very, very... You don't have them either. Well, sometimes you do have them, and they look a little bit like this. You do? Fantastic. Now, cockroaches are like worms and snails. They like to eat the dead leaves. But what we have today is we've got a giant burrowing cockroach, which is an Australian one.
She was a bit hard to find. She was burrowing under the leaves.
So if you look at our giant burrowing cockroach, it's very, very big, isn't it? But she's very, very safe, very, very friendly.
Now, sometimes cockroaches have a bit of a bad reputation. Some people don't like cockroaches, but I love cockroaches because they eat up all the leaves and compost the leaves for the garden. Now, do you know, Dion, that cockroaches are actually really clean? because they have to be clean because they don't breathe through their mouth like you and I do. They breathe through little tiny holes in their skin, their exoskeleton, the shell here. So they've got to stay clean, otherwise they can't breathe very well. So today, when we're playing in Science Time, you'll be able to come and have a little pat of our pet cockroach.
Very cool indeed.
Isn't she gorgeous?
So we have lots of things to talk about and look at in Science Time today. So ready, set, go! Explore the room, see what you can find, and enjoy yourselves.
So while everyone's having a play, let's go have a closer look at some autumn trees. Come with me. Here we are outside Questacon. Here in Canberra, we've got lots of lovely deciduous trees that change colour in the autumn time. Have you ever wondered why do trees have leaves? Well, they use their leaves to get energy. They turn the sun's rays into energy using this green colour called chlorophyll. It's a bit like the tree's own solar panels. We call this photosynthesis. Can you say that word with me? Photosynthesis. That just means turning the sunlight into energy for the tree to grow. But in the autumn time and the winter, there's not as much sun. The days get shorter and it gets freezing cold. So cold that this leaf would freeze. Not good for the leaf, and certainly not good for the tree. So the tree now has lots of energy stored up from the summer, and it doesn't need its leaves anymore in the winter, and it decides to drop its leaves. So the first thing it does is stop making this lovely green colour, the chlorophyll. And without the green colour, that starts to disappear, and you can see other colours coming onto the leaf. You can see lovely yellow shining through. Soon, there's not much colour at all, except this brown colour. And then it's time for the leaf to fall onto the ground, where the little bugs turn it into compost, and that helps feed the tree during the winter time. Do you know what my favourite thing to do in autumn is? Play in the leaves. Now, Dion loves playing in the leaves too. He said he was going to come and play in the leaves with me, but I can't see him anywhere. Dion! Dion, where are you? Dion! Dion, where are you? I wonder where Dion is. Wow, look at this huge pile of leaves. I wonder who raked all these up. Oh, here's a nice leaf. Dion would love this one. I'll have to show it to him when we see him. But I wonder where he is. He can't be far away. Let's all call Dion together one more time. Can you help me? I'll count to three and then we'll yell loudly, Dion! Ready? All together. One, two, three. Dion!
Surprise!
What a great hiding spot.
It's so much fun to play in leaves. You can play in leaves at home as well.
Let's go back and see what's happening at Science Time.
What we're going to do now is we're going to have a look at something called a terrarium, and BJ is going to show us how to make one at home.
So everyone, can you show all the boys and girls your terrariums that you made? What a terrarium is, it's where we plant seeds and we can watch them grow. So you can do this at home. You just need two cups like this. And in one of the cups, you put some wet cotton wool. This is all wet and soggy. It's been in water. So we put some cotton wool in the bottom of it like that. Then, Dion, can you sprinkle in some alfalfa seeds? Sprinkle, sprinkle. You don't need too many seeds. Sprinkle, sprinkle. Well done. Thank you. Now we're going to use the second cup to put a lid on top of our terrarium.
Then you stick it on.
Then you stick it on.
And
you stick it all over.
So we'll use some sticky tape to stick it all together.
Now, as you stick it together, this is called a terrarium, and that means you don't have to water it. It's got its own little water cycle happening in here. The water will evaporate and then condense and come back down again and keep on going round. So you don't need to water your seeds in a terrarium, but these seeds do need something to help them grow. What do seeds need to help them grow?
Water.
Lots of water. What else? Something that lives up in the sky.
The rain.
The rain is like the water, isn't it? Yep. And you're right, sunshine. You need lots of sunshine to help your seeds grow in the terrarium. So you can put it on the shelf in a nice sunny place. And have a look, close look. They're not growing yet, but in a few days, they're going to start to grow and they will be this big. Wow.
Like this big.
Like that big, because you grow too, don't you? Yes, you do. And every day they'll grow a little bit more and a little bit more. And they will be really, really big. So you can make a terrarium at home and watch your seeds grow. Excellent. So you and I are going to take our terrariums home and watch them grow. Dion's got something else for us now before we leave.
So we've got some things to take home now. So the first thing we can take home is a parent information sheet. These ones for the parents to give you an idea of what to do at home and how you can learn about autumn and that sort of stuff. The next thing we have is we've got a picture for the kids to take home. So what is this a picture of? Can anyone tell me? What's this here? What's this a pile of?
Leaves.
Yeah, it's a big pile of leaves. Leaves are really fun to play with. So make sure that you get a colouring in sheet so you can take home.
Mommy.
But before we finish, we're going to say goodbye to all the boys and girls at home.
So can everyone look at the boys and girls at home?
Can everyone say bye, boys and girls at home?
And wave and say bye.
See you next science time.
See you next science time.
Does everyone want to come and get a sheet?
Questacon Science Time is held at Questacon in Canberra, Tuesday to Friday during school terms. Bookings are essential. For further information, go to our website at questacon.edu.au. See you next Science Time.